Hi everyone, welcome to the next session of geotechnical engineering 1, problems on permeability and effective stress. And coming to the problem, a horizontal stratified soil deposit consists of three layers of each uniform in itself. The permeability of these layers are 88 into 10 to the power of minus 4 centimeter per second, 52 into 10 to the power of minus 4 centimeter per second, and 6 into 10 to the power of minus 4 centimeter per second, and their thicknesses are 7 meter, 3 meter, and 10 meter respectively. Find the effective average permeability of the deposit in the horizontal as well as vertical direction. If you see here, this is the problem they are given. And they give the type of the soil layer. They are considered three type of soil layers. In three type of soil layers, they calculated the coefficient of permeability in first layer, coefficient of permeability in second layer, as well as coefficient of permeability in third layer. The first layer having thickness of 7 meter and third layer having thickness of 3 meter and third layer having thickness of 10 meter and stratified soil having uniform itself in all directions. The uniform soil properties are there. And again, if you see here 8 into 10 to the power of minus 4 centimeter per second, this is the water flowing in horizontal direction as well as water flowing in the vertical direction. For the all these type of layers, water flowing in the horizontal direction and the water flowing in the vertical direction, that we should have to calculate. And these type of formulas already we have discussed in our concept, when flow of water through the stratified soil in a horizontal direction as well as flow of water to the perpendicular to the direction, that we should have to solve. And first we should have to write the given data. The given data is coefficient of permeability in layer 1, K1 equal to 8 into 10 to the power of 4 centimeter per second. Height of the first layer or thickness of the layer 1 equal to 7 meter. And coefficient of permeability in second layer equal to 52 into 10 to the power of minus 4 centimeter per second. And thickness of the second layer H2 equal to 3 meters. And coefficient of permeability in third layer equal to 6 into 10 to the power of minus 4 centimeter per second, or height of the soil layer equal to H3 equal to 10 meters. The average coefficient of permeability in the horizontal direction, that means when flow of water through the soil medium happening in the horizontal direction, suppose if you consider this is the soil mass and this is the first layer and this is the second layer. For this different type of layers, when the water flowing in this direction, as well as in this direction, we should have to calculate the coefficient of permeability. The average coefficient of permeability, we are having the formula KH or KX in horizontal direction equal to K1 H1 plus K2 H2 plus K3 H3 divided by H1 plus H2 plus H3, where this is H1 and this is H2 and this is H3 layer. And by substituting these above values in this formula, you may get the average coefficient of permeability by combining for all these three type of layers. By combining the average three coefficient of permeability will coming these three layers equal to, where K1 is the coefficient of permeability 8 into 10 to the power of minus 4. That means this coefficient of permeability, it will be same for all type of soil mass. Hence K1 into H1 8 into 7 plus 52 into 3 plus 6 into 10 into 10 to the power of minus 4 divided by H1 plus H2 plus H3. That means thickness of the layer 1 plus thickness of the layer 2 plus thickness of the layer 3. 10 plus 3 plus 7, 20 meters is the coefficient of permeability. The average coefficient of permeability for these three type of soils in the horizontal direction, KH or KX, equal to 13.6 into 10 to the power of minus 4 centimeter per second. 13.6 into 10 to the power of minus 4 centimeter per second is the coefficient of permeability flowing through that particular type of the soil mass. And the next if you coming next coming to the second condition, that second condition is effective average permeability of the soil mass in all direction we have taken 13.6 into 10 power minus 3 millimeter per second. Now when water is flowing in the vertical direction, what is the average coefficient of permeability that we should have to calculate? That means if water is flowing in this direction as well as water going this direction, in this direction, in this direction, the average coefficient of permeability of the flow of water through this vertical direction, that we should have to calculate. That coefficient of permeability in vertical direction KB equal to, or KZ equal to, in vertical direction equal to head H divided by total height of the thickness of the clay layer, H divided by H1 divided by K1 plus H2 divided by K2 plus H3 divided by K3. By substituting in this way, we can calculate the coefficient of permeability, average coefficient of permeability flowing water through this each individual layer combined with three layers. That combined three layers coefficient of permeability equal to total thickness of the soil layer 7310 meters, that means total 20 divided by H1, where thickness of the layer H1 7 meters and thickness of the second layer 3 and the thickness of the third layer 10 divided by K1 8 into 10 to the power minus 4, 52 into 10 to the power minus 4 and 6 into 10 to the power of minus 4. By substituting all these parameters, we are getting the average permeability in the horizontal direction equal to 7.7 into 10 to the power of minus 4 centimeter per second. This is the effective average permeability of the soil mass in the vertical direction, which gives this value as equal to 7.7 into 10 power 3 minus mm per second. In this way, we will calculate the average coefficient of permeability in the vertical direction as well as in the horizontal direction. Next, we will see few more problems based on the concept of confined aquifer and the unconfined aquifer. And coming to the problem, an unconfined aquifer is known to be 30 meter thick below the water table. Here there is a water table present here. In this water table, unconfined aquifer having thickness of 32 meter and a constant discharge of 2 cubic meter per minute is pumped out of the aquifer through a tube well till the water level in the tube well becomes steady. If you consider here, in this water they are pumping out this water to the ground level to reach the constant water level applicable for here, and with 2 meter cube per minute they are pumping out of this water. And if you see here, the two observation wells are provided at a distance of 50 meter and 70 meter from the tube well, falls through shows falls of 3 meters of the fall and 0.7 meter respectively from their static water level. If you see here, this is the static water level surface, and here they made one observation well, again here they made one other observation well. The first observation well is 15 meter from this present tube well, and this periodic surface it's get down observed as 3 meters, and again they are considered this length as 70 meter. In 70 meter they consider this periodic level surface decreased was 0.70 meters. For this condition, we should have to calculate the coefficient of permeability through this particular type of the soil mass. And we know the formula coefficient of permeability through unconfined soil mass. For this unconfined soil mass of the condition, we should have to calculate coefficient of permeability K equal to Q into log base E into R2 divided by R1 divided by pi Z2 square minus Z1 square, where Q is the coefficient of permeability for 2.303 constant value we should have to substitute. And 2 log base 10 into where discharge of the soil mass we are giving in the problem as 2, and log base 10 into R2 radius of the second observation well divided by radius of the first observation well, and that means 70 divided by 15 into in terms of centimeter meter we are getting substituting in terms of centimeter meter will be get converted to centimeter, and so 100 divided by pi into Z2 square minus Z1 square, that means perimeter of this cylindrical surface well we are taking it as 60 times, that means 60 into pi is the perimeter of the well, and Z2 square minus Z1 square, that means Z2 square minus Z1 square means this thickness of the layer with this observation well. By considering this observation tube well and this observation tube well, that means 31.3 square That means in 32.0 we are subtracting this 0.70 value. We are getting this height of the tube L as 31.30 square minus 3 meters observation well we are taking from this total entire thickness of the confined unconfined aquifer. That means 32 minus 3, which gives the 29 square. And by substituting all these values in this formula, we are getting the coefficient of permeability to unconfined aquifer equal to 1.18 into 10 to the power of minus 1 mm per second. In this way, we will calculate the coefficient of permeability, where here Q 2.303 is the average value, Q is the discharge 2 cubic meter to tube well, and R2, R1 are the radius of the two wells, radius of the tube wells for this particular type of the problem. In this way, we will calculate the coefficient of permeability of the soil mass. Next, we will solve one more problem based on the variable head or based on the falling head. How the coefficient of permeability it may get vary, or different type of cross section of the standard pipe, how the coefficient will may get changed, that we will see. And coming to here, a sample in a variable head permeability perimeter is 8 cm in diameter and 10 cm height. The permeability of the sample is estimated to be 10 into 10 to the power of minus 4 cm per second. If it is desired that the head in the standard pipe should be fall from 24 cm to 12 cm in 3 minutes, determine the size of the standard pipe which should be used. That means, suppose if you consider here, this is your setup for this falling head test. In this falling head test, here this is the cross section. This is the cross section of the pipe you are providing. Suppose this is the cross section of the pipe you are providing, and here we are providing some reservoir tank. From this reservoir tank, we are filling the water. And this is the cross section area of the sample, and from this cross section area we are keeping one more set to collection water from here. But here we are not taking any collection of water through this jar. Only we are interested in this condition is to measure the how much amount of water level is falling in the initial stage after releasing of wall into this condition. That means here we will provide one inlet wall. After entering of water into the level, how much this level is get decreased, that we should have to calculate first. And coming to here, first we should have to write the all given parameters. And variable head parameter, soil sample diameter is 8 cm square. That means the soil sample diameter in a circular cross section, they are given. There is no circular. Okay, if you see here in this, suppose if you see here, this is your the soil sample in a circular direction. For this soil sample in a circular direction, it is having the sample diameter as 8 cm and the height of this sample as 10 cm and permeability approximately it will be 10 into 10 to the power of minus 4 cm per second. For this particular type of the sample permeability approximately they are given this value, where h1 is the 24 cm and h2 is the 12 cm at 180 seconds. What here it's indicates means, suppose this is your standard cross section, standard pipe with a cross sectional area as E, and D is the diameter, and here these are the readings. And if you see here, first initial height of the sample H1 is at this 24 level, where here H1 equal to 24 centimeter, H1 equal to 24 centimeter. When water get reducing from this 24 centimeter to this level, from this level to water get reducing, that the height H2 equal to 12 centimeter will be falling within the 180 second. That means 3 minutes it taken to fall water when flowing through this particular type of soil sample from this height to this height as 3 minutes. Substituting in this equation, the coefficient of permeability for variable head, we are having the formula coefficient of permeability K equal to coefficient of permeability formula K equal to 2.303 into AL divided by capital AT into log base 10 H1 divided by H2, where this is the formula will be useful for calculation of the coefficient of permeability for variable head or for fine grain soils, where 2.303 is the constant value and A is the cross sectional area of this standard tube. The cross sectional area of the standard tube we don't know, that we should have to calculate by using this formula. And where L is the length of the sample, that length of the flow path or length of the water flowing the sample, they are given in the problem as 10 meters. And log base 10 into height of water head loss from sample 1 to from first height to second height, that means log base 10 into H1 24 divided by H2 12, and where A is the perimeter of the soil sample, that means pi into perimeter of the soil sample, they are given the problem D equal to R by 2 radius, or R equal to D equal to R by 2, R equal to D equal to R by 2, diameter equal to by diameter, we are calculating this value pi d into pi by 4 d square or pi r equal to 180, where 180 is the time taken for this particular type of the cross section in log base 10 into 24 divided by 12. And where cross section area of the standard pipe, that we should have to calculate this cross section area of the standard pipe, A equal to this A value, we should have to calculate A equal to pi into 16 into 180 divided by 2.303 into 10 to the power of 4 into log base 10 to the square, log base 10 to the square, that will be 24 divided by 12. If you substitute, get the log base 10 to where A equal to 1.305 is the cross section area of the standard pipe. The flow of water through this soil sample, it will may depend upon the cross section area, how much you are providing for this standard pipe also. The diameter of the sample is D, then we should have to calculate the formula. The diameter of the sample D, we should have to calculate area of the cross section of the standard pipe A equal to pi by 4 into D square, where capital D equal to square root of 4 into cross section of the standard pipe divided by pi, which gives the 1.29 centimeter. This is the 1.29 centimeter or 12 mm is the cross sectional diameter of the standard pipe. Approximately the standard pipe should be in 30 mm in a diameter. The standard pipe, if you provide 30 mm in a diameter, the flow of water will be happening, will falling from 24 to 12 centimeter in 3 minutes. The coefficient of permeability, it will be 10 into 10 to the power of minus 4 centimeter per second. In this way, we will calculate the coefficient of permeability in a different type of soil condition by using the laboratory experiment. This is the topic for coefficient of permeability calculation. Thank you.